Assalamu alaikum, dear learners. I am Shaheen Akhtar, Assistant Teacher English, City Government Girls High School. So, dear learners, hope that all of you are keeping well and have already coped with the present situation. So, learners, this is my third class with you. In my last two classes, I discussed changing speeches on assertive sentences and on interrogative sentences. Today, I will try to discuss changing speeches on imperative sentences. So, before going to change imperative or direct speeches into indirect, we will try to know what is an imperative sentence. The sentence which is used to convey a command or an order or a suggestion or a request or a forbiddance is called imperative sentence. Basically, an imperative sentence always takes the second person for the subject, but most of the time the subject remains hidden. Let's have some examples, then you will understand it better.
Okay. Give me a glass of water. Do it. Don't do it.
So, dear learners, we can see that the imperative sentence starts with the verb directly. We don't see any subject before the verb. So, we will learn how to change those kind of imperative direct sentences into indirect. So, as you know, there are some common rules and there are some specific rules we follow to change speeches. We followed to change assertive sentences, and we followed to change interrogative sentences. In the same way, we will follow some common rules and some specific rules to change imperative direct speeches into indirect. So, first one is the changing of reporting verb. Okay, rule number one. In an imperative sentence, the reporting verb can be changed to tell, order, command, request, advice, urge, bid, forbid, propose, suggest, beg, etc. So, in an imperative sentence, the reporting verb can be changed to tell, order, command, request, advise, urge, bid, forbid, propose, suggest, beg, etc. based on the meaning of the sentence. At first, we have to understand the meaning of the sentence, then we can choose any of the verbs to replace the reporting verb. Okay, now rule number two. We will use to as a connector or linker. If the imperative sentence is positive, then we will use to as a connector, but if the imperative sentence is in negative, then we will use not to as a connector or linker. So, dear learners, the other changes of verb and changes of persons will remain as a rule, we will follow as a set rule. Okay, now we will try to do some exercises. Number one, the man said to him, please lend me the book. Okay, dear learners, we can see that the reported speech expresses a request of the man. So we can use request to replace this reporting verb, and we will use to as a connector, and other changes of verb and tense and person will be remain same as we followed in changing assertive and interrogative sentences. The man requested him to lend him the book. Okay. Number two, mother said to him, always speak the truth. So we can see that the reported speech expresses, it may be order or it may be advice also. So we can use order or advice to replace this reporting verb. Mother ordered, or we can write advised him to speak the truth always. So we replace the adverb at the end of the sentence. Okay, now I'm writing another one. Number three. Father said to him, do not waste your time. So we can see that the reported speech expresses a forbiddance. So in that case, we can use forbid to replace the reporting verb. So we will use forbid, the past form of forbid. Father forbade him to waste his time. So dear learners, we can see that we don't use not here. We don't use any negative sense after to, as we use forbade, which gives the negative sense. So we should not use not in the direct speech. Father forbade him to waste time. We can change it in another way also. Or we can write, father ordered, or we can write advised him not to waste his time. So here you can see that we use not in direct speech. When we use order or advised, then we have to use the negative sense. When we use forbade, then we will not use not in the indirect speech. Father forbid him to waste his time, or we can write, we can change it in this way. Father ordered or advised him not to waste his time. Okay. Number four. Number four. The beggar said to the man, "Give me some food." So what can you see? You see that the reported speech, in the reported speech, the beggar is begging from the man some food. So we can use beg to replace the reporting verb. The beggar begged the man to give him some food. Okay. So we use begged, the past form of the beg, to replace the reporting verb. So we will choose those verb based on the meaning of the sentence, based on the meaning of the reported speech. We'll try to mean the meaning of the reported speech, and we will use or choose the verbs from the list. Okay, now I'm doing number five. The general said to the soldiers, "March on." So the reported speech expresses command or order of the general. So we can use order or command to replace the reporting verb. I'm writing, the general ordered or commanded the soldiers to march on. So, dear learners, I think you have got and you have learned the rules, and you would be able to change the imperative direct speeches into indirect. Now I'm writing two another sentences on imperative sentence. Those are a little bit different from those imperative sentences. Number one. The chairperson said, "Let us drop the matter. Number two, the girl said to the teacher, "Let me do it." Good dear learners, when there is letters in the direct speech, these letters indicate proposal or suggestion. In that case, we will use propose or suggest to replace the reporting verb. And let is replaced by should. And we will use that as a connector. In the five other sentences we used two as a connector. But in this kind of sentence, where let us indicates, proposal or suggestion, then we will use that as a connector, and this let will be replaced by should. Okay, see the change. The chairperson, proposed that. So dear learners, look at, we don't use to, we are using that as a connector. The chairperson proposed that they, us be changed to they. They should. Let is replaced by should. Should. That they should drop the matter. Okay. But dear learners, when let indicates permission, doesn't express proposal or suggestion, then we will use might or might be allowed to replace let. But we will use that as a connector. But in this in the first sentence, we use should to replace let. But this let doesn't indicate a proposal or suggestion, only indicates permission. Then we will use might or might be allowed to replace let. So the change. The girl, as the girl is talking to the teacher, so we can use a request to replace reporting verb. The girl requested the teacher. The girl requested the teacher that first person pronoun will be changed according to the subject of the reporting speech. She. The teacher that she might do that. Or dear learners, we can write it in another way. The girl requested the teacher that she might be allowed to do that. It will be changed to that. So we can use only might, or we can use might be allowed to instead of let. To replace let, we can use might or might be allowed to. So dear learners, hope that you have understood the rules of changing imperative direct speeches into indirect. So dear learners, to practice more, I'm giving you some HW. You will do it in your homework, and you will do it in your home, and we'll send in our Facebook page of the school. So dear learners, change the following imperative sentence into indirect speech. The father said, don't tell a lie. Number one. Number two, he said, let me help you. Number three, mother said to me, go to bed at once. Number four, the farmer said, let us dig the soil. Number five, the teacher said to the students, let us finish today. Number six, the student said to the headmaster, sir, grant me a full-free studentship, please. Number seven, the teacher said, do not laugh at the poor. Number eight, the police said to the hesitating people, stop shouting. Number 9, Rahman said to the boys, speak in English, please. Number 10, the chairperson said, let us drop the matter. Okay, dear learners, hope that you will do it in your home and send it to the Facebook page of our school. Hope that all of you are regular in your studies. So keep watching our online classes. Thank you all.